Snannel Acuity chart. So this is, I discussed that Snannel Acuity is written as a fraction, which is distance at which the chart is viewed, divided by the distance at which the letter subtends and subtends 5 minutes of arc. Okay. So typically this Snannel chart, you are sitting at around 20 feet away, which is 6 meters. So 6 meters. So ideally, if somebody is sitting 6 meters away, then whichever line here is marked as 6 meter, okay, here the third line from the bottom, this is 6 meters. So that line, every letter should subtend angle of 5 degrees, 5 minutes of arc. 5 minutes of arc means 60 degrees, 30 degrees. So 30 degrees it should subtend on the eye. So so if somebody is like able to see from 6 feet, somebody is only able to see, so from 6 meters, somebody is able to only see the top one, 60 meters. So the acuity will be 6 by 60. Okay. If you are able to read the next one, 6 by 30, I think. Okay. 6 by 30, 6 by 24, 6 by 18, like that. Okay. So ideally, one should be able to read the at least the sixth line. Okay. Number three from the bottom. When you are 20 feet away. Okay. Or 6 meters away. So you should be able to read that. That is considered as normal vision. Under which it will subtend a 5 degree angle on your. On your eyes, on your cornea. Vision of 6 by 60 means that from 6 meters, the subject can just read a letter which someone, subject can read a letter which someone with a normal vision would be able to see from 60 meters. If someone is able, to say read 3, say on the fourth from the bottom, if somebody is able to read just one letter, say two, somebody makes one mistake, okay, out of the six characters, somebody makes one mistake, then the Snannel acuity is given by 6 by 30, say, or whatever it is, 6 by 6 or 6 by 12 minus one. Okay, the number of errors which somebody makes. So we tell 6 by 30 minus 1, 6 by 30 minus 2, or 6 by 12 minus 1, 6 by 12 minus 2. If somebody makes more than 2 errors, then you basically say that line is, the person is not able to read that one. So you go back and report the Snannel acuity as one below that. So problems with the Snannel chart is, unequal number of letters, ठीक है, per line. So unequal number of letters per line. एक ऊपर वाले में सिर्फ एक letter है, नीचे छह letters, many more letters. And then the progression of letter size is not regular, nor the spacing between the letters. Some letters are easier to read than others. ठीक है, some letters are easier to read than others. Sometimes for illiterate patients, a tumbling E chart is used. ठीक है, tumbling E chart क्या होता है? एक लेट्स सो टम्बलिंग ई चार्ट इज ए चार्ट विथ ई इज रिटन लाइक दिस सो समबडी विल बी समबडी शुड बी एबल टू टेल की एंड दिस विल बी रिड्यूसिंग फ्रॉम इन साइज So somebody who is illiterate and not able to read these characters, then you can use a tumbling E chart to just ask them that in which direction the E is pointing, top, bottom, left, right. Okay. So something of that sort. The octotypes of the Snellen chart, octotypes are these characters. Okay, the octotypes of the Snellen chart, it has two characteristics. One is the thickness of the lines equals the thickness of the white spaces. Okay, thickness of the lines equals the thickness of the white spaces.
For example, this thickness here is equal to the thickness of this white space. Okay, all the thickness of the lines are equal to the thickness of the, they try to do it, but it is not possible for every letter. For example, C, the thickness of the line equal to thickness of this white space between the ends of the character.
Okay. Next.
Height and width of each octotype is 5 times the thickness of the line.
ठीक है यहाँ पे दिस वन इज से 1 minute ऑफ आर्क इज द हैंड ऑफ द सी
बट द कंप्लीट इज हाइट इज 5 टाइम्स दैट ऑफ द सो हाइट ऑफ द ईच कैरेक्टर इज 5 टाइम्स दैट ऑफ द थिकनेस ऑफ द लाइन ओनली 10 लेटर्स व्हिच आर ओनली 10 लेटर्स व्हिच आर सी डी ई एफ एल एन ओ पी टी जेड आर यूज्ड C D E F L N O P T Z. C D E F N. Sorry, F L N O P T Z. These are the characters that are typically used. As per British Standards Institution, C D E F H. K N P R U V Z. These are also used. Then there is a chart called a logMAR chart. LogMAR chart. In this, it is a more accurate estimate. It gives a more accurate estimate of visual acuity. Logmar chart gives a more accurate estimate of the visual acuity.
Okay.
Each line has some number of test letters. Each line has some number of test letters. So this is a logmar chart.
Each line has same number, sorry, not sum. Each line has same number of test letters. Each line has same number of test letters. Okay, on the logMAR chart.
Letter size and spacing between lines.
Letter size and spacing between lines varies as varies logarithmically.
Letter size and spacing between lines varies logarithmically. Logmar visual acuity is given by logmar visual acuity is given by 0.1 plus logmar value of the best line read minus 0.02 multiplied by number of letters read in the next line. Okay, in the next line, sorry, number of letters read. Okay, in the same line, the last line, if somebody makes errors, then you subtract minus 0.02 to number of letters read. So logmar is given by for example, this is in foot. Somebody has 20 by 200 vision. In meter, it will be 6 by 60. In decimals, this will be 0.1, and in logmar, this will be. You basically do this will be 0.1. Sorry, this will be 1.0. ठीक है logmar value उस chart का देखना है वहाँ पर. So logmar value for that chart will be let me see if I can
this chart itself might not be very clear. We have this chart in the lab in that screen, so you can use that to see. But every line has a logMAR value. Okay, so the top one, the logMAR is 1, and as you go down, okay, so the perfect vision is 20 by 20 or 6 by 6, 20 by 20 in meters, right? You go down like 20 by 60, then 20 by 125, sorry, 20 by 20 by 25, so this is 160, it's 20 by 125, 20 by 80. So like this, you can go up to 20 by 20, which will be 6 by 6 here. And this will be 6 by 6 means decimal mein ye aayega 1. And in logMAR, it will be log of, this is basically log of 1 by 0.1. Theek hai? This one. This one will be log of 1 by, isko nikaliye meters mein hoga 6 by 48. Because this is in feet. So 20 meters is approximately 6 feet. 160 meters is approximately 48 feet. 160 feet. 160 feet is approximately 48 meters. So 6 by 48, which will be given by 0.125, and its ka lag, this will be 1 by 0.125, which will be given as 0.9. So similarly, you go down. Here it will be log of 1 by 1, which is 0. So perfect vision on the logMAR chart is 0. Then Cardiff Acuity cards are used for visual acuity for toddlers.
So they you have to show them some toys, some cars, something of that sort. So Cardiff Acuity chart, CRDIFF. Cardiff University, jo hamara IIT ka collaboration. So that's where this got developed. Cardiff Acuity cards.
Then colors and color and contrast. Then write color and contrast tests. Human retina is able to detect a difference of 1 nanometer in wavelength between blue and green. So human so this is the these are we have three different types of cones. The S type, M type, and L type. Okay? The S type are sensitive to the zones between 400 nanometers to 500 nanometers type, 600, 550 nanometers. Then you have an overlap of between green and red, okay, which is 500 to 700. Okay? Human retina is able to detect a difference of 1 nanometer in wavelength between blue-green. Blue-green regions between blue blue-green and yellow at violet and red ends, a difference of greater than 4 nanometer is required. Theek hai? At towards the end of violet means towards the right side of this chart, more than 4 nanometer difference is required for you to be able to separate these two colors, tell that these are two different colors. But on this region, you are more sensitive, like 1 nanometer difference also, somebody can be able to say that there is a difference in color. Three types of cones with different but overlapping color sensitivities are responsible for color detection. Shorter wavelengths tend to stimulate all three cone classes. Shorter wavelengths tend to stimulate all the three cone classes. colors can be, so there are three types of cones, which is L for red, M for green, and S for blue. Color is specified by three properties. Color can also be specified as by three properties of hue, saturation, and brightness. Color can also be specified like in computer, we represent color as red, green, blue, RGB. You can also represent as HSV, hue, saturation, and value. देखो ह्यू क्या होता है. ह्यू इज अ पर्टिकुलर, जैसे एक इफ यू टेक ए रेड कलर का, यू टेक वन ब्रश स्ट्रोक, यू पुट वंस देन यू गेट रेड कलर, यू पुट इट ट्वाइस देन यू हैव डीपर कलर ऑफ द सेम ह्यू. सो ह्यू इज व्हिच कलर इट इज. सैचुरेशन इज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स ओवर एंड ओवर यू हैव पुट. ब्राइटनेस इज दैट कलर मे हैव ए यू नो हाउ शाइनी दैट कलर इज. सो these are two different systems of representing color, although computers try to do some kind of formula conversion between RGB and HSV, but they are essentially different ways of representing color. Let's come back. So deficiencies can be, so deficiency in color vision can be either monochromat, dichromat, or anomalous trichromat, depending on the number of cone pigments affected. The problem can be either monochromat, dichromat, or trichromat, or anomalous trichromat, depending on number of cone pigments affected. Only monochromats are completely colorblind. Only monochromats jinko hota hai, they can only see black and white or grayscale. But everybody else can see some color. So then there is this concept of now again, what is the property? Does light have a particular color? Does light have a color? Huh? Kaun sa?
Red light view. What is the color? Is there is color is a property of light, or is it a property of your eye? Because your cones, rods, and the rods, basically there is a perception of like those rods or those cones are firing, and those cones are basically taking the information to brain, which is interpreting it as red. But as such, a light frequency, which when it is entering, the color is not property of that light. If somebody now again, this can also be a question that what I am perceiving as red in my brain, are you perceiving in the same way? Or just because from the childhood we have all asked, we are all told that okay, this is red. Understand? It's a think about it, means it may be just everybody is programmed to tell a thing as red, but what you are seeing in the brain may be different, right? Because depending on how you are programming your brain. So again, there may be animals, say if their frequency zones for these three are little different, then they might perceive the same thing in a different way. Even your own, like your sensitivity, they are little shifted on this. What you might perceive, the other person may perceive differently. So it is a property of the visual system, not the property of the light. And again, light when a particular frequency, for example, lasers can generate very sharp frequencies, means a particular frequency of light. But if I shine, say, a red light and a yellow light, red light and a green light on a white sheet, what will you see? Red light and green light on a white sheet on one point, what will you see? What color will you see? Yellow you will see. Okay, red and green mix, and you will get, because your both red cones are getting excited and your green cones are getting excited, so you will get your eye thinks, your basically your visual system interprets as a sum of as a yellow light. Okay, but on the frequency chart also,
means if I look at, when I say suppose this is the frequency of the red light, okay, and suppose this is the frequency of the yellow light, green light, okay. When these are falling over your eye, okay, eye is interpreting it as yellow light, okay. Now maybe there is a frequency which on its own can also excite yellow light. Yellow means it can excite in your brain as if it's yellow. But that, if you do a spectro, if you take a spectrophotometer and look at the both of these lights, both are appearing yellow to you. Both are appearing to your eye, it is both of them are appearing yellow. But if you take a spectrophotometer and look at this light, you will see that it will produce two peaks on the spectrophotometer on the frequency. This is the frequency side. So you will produce two peaks, while this might produce one peak at the center. Understand? So both of these, your eyes are perceiving they are yellow, but on the spectrophotometer they might appear different. So similarly, for example, these LED lights, they are appearing white. You might have some other white light source like tube lights. Say tube light versus a yellow light, if you look at their whiteness, they might look white, but when you take a spectrophotometer and look at the frequency division, you might see that they might have different, right? So the light which you perceive, the color of light, is not unique. What I'm saying, different frequencies, combination of frequencies can produce the same light, same color, or a single frequency can also produce the same color, depending on which cones it is, which rods or cones it is excited. And this is a property of the visual system, not of the light itself.
Again, that has to be found out through spectrophotometer. Maybe this is not same, because if there is a green frequency,
there is a frequency which I produce on this, say, you know, a frequency I produce here, okay? Another frequency I produce here, and another frequency I produce here. Only three frequencies, three lasers, exactly sharp frequencies at these two points. I combine them and then I diffuse them and then show to you. It will appear white to you, completely white. But there are three frequencies. And if I take all the frequencies, okay, maybe 15 or 100 frequencies, combine them and show to you, it will also appear to white.
So then you have to take a spectrophotometer and see actually, you know, how this light is getting, the frequencies, how they are getting divided.
And then color of object is because of what? Light falling on it and then reflecting from it. But what is the color which, the color which you see is because of what?
Right, the colors which it absorbs in the white light, suppose there are red frequencies, there are three frequencies, red, green and blue, say. But there are, if you take, there can be multiple frequencies. Jo rainbow mein aata hai, no? Vidyor, seven frequencies, they're because they are visible, but there may be other frequencies also. So they are, suppose a white light is falling on it and only yellow is getting reflected, means it is absorbing everything else. Okay. So if I put a blue light, ye room ka sara lights blue kar de. So yellow is a property of what? Generally, red and green frequencies are getting reflected, right? So if in this room I make it completely yellow, completely blue, only blue lights, okay, blue LEDs, then these will appear as what? What color? Black, no? Because if you put blue light completely, this room is only blue frequency, blue single frequency blue light. This will all appear as these chairs will appear. Your chairs blue dikhenge because they are programmed to reflect blue light. But if you make it all red, you will see these chairs will appear as black. Okay. But these will appear as red because green wala component to hai nahi. Green and red mixing, they are reflecting green and red spectrum or us range. So if there is only green light, only blue light, this will also appear as black. But if I put red light, the chairs will appear as black, these will appear as red. Okay?
what is getting reflected? What is available? It can only reflect that. If there is no, that light is not available, it's not reflected. So, this is called as additive mix. In generally light terms, we have additive mixing. And
so if you throw, if I have a white paper and I throw lights on it, okay, three lights, red, green and blue, because the light, white paper is programmed to reflect every frequency, okay? So whatever light is getting, whatever light is falling over it, it will reflect everything. So if there are mixing, it will be all additive mixing. But in terms of pigments, pigments mean jahan pe painting karte hain, kabhi red, green or blue ko milaya, painting karte hain, does it become white?
It will not become white, it will become black, right? Because the opposite karta hai, because the red pigment is programmed to absorb everything and reflect red, okay? And then green one is programmed to absorb even red and only reflect green. So once you mix them, even green is absorbed, right? Because it is absorbed, sorry, even red is absorbed because it is programmed to, it is, its property is to absorb that, okay? So that's why there is different color mixing. One is if you have reflective,
the light is falling and being
reflected of something, reflected of a white whiteboard or something, it will be additive color mixing. If it is pigments, like you are painting something with different pigments which are absorbent properties, then you will have subtracting color mixing.
But this is just by the by, but these are yeah, these are important to understand when you look at certain frequency of light. The same light color can come out of different ways. There cannot be, it's not that every red is not equal or every yellow is not equal. They can be made out in different ways. Then these are the Ishara plates which are used for color blindness testing. So if you cannot see the numbers which are there, then there may be some color blindness or part of color blindness present. So first one is 12, 6, 42. This one is blank. Third one doesn't.
This is used for just identifying bluff to nahi maar rahe.
Then there are contrast tests. Contrast tests are like there can be like somebody may have very good visual acuity, may also have
no color blindness, but contrast problem might also be there. So contrast, like you change the
number of lines per number of lines or number, yes, sinusoids. These are basically two-dimensional sinusoids. So and with angles, so different angle. So you basically, the patient has to tell that what is the angle, whether it is looking at right, top, left, or something of that. So three options are there, and these contrast bands keep on increasing as they go down.
It's a low resolution, so I don't expect this is as good as the real test. There can also test which is Pelli-Robinson test, where you reduce the contrast with respect to background as you go down and you try to read how many letters are there. Then dark adaptation. So dark adaptation, the eye is sensitive to the light over a 6 log range. Okay?
Sensitive to a to light over a 6 log range means 1 is to 1 million. Okay? 1 is to 1 million range may it can detect.
During dark adaptation, the normal eye takes about 20 minutes to change in sensitivity by 3 log units. During dark adaptation means if the light goes, if the light suddenly goes off or there is darkness, your eyes try to accommodate, okay, accommodate, and immediately you will feel as if it is dark. But if you stay in that dark for some time, eyes automatically adapt and you start looking, seeing things when it is initially not visible. And that time, the amount of time which is taken is plotted here in this form. So one method of measurement of this is, so retinal disease may affect dark adaptation, usually by reducing the threshold.
In many diseases, the time course of dark adaptation is also changed. There is the method of measurement is the Goldman-Weekers dark adaptometer.
Goldman-Weekers. Dark adaptometer.
ठीक है. So in this
the subject is dark adapted for at least 30 minutes.
A dimly lit target is then presented to the eye to be tested. The weakest light stimulus a patient is able to see, starting at a low level and working upwards, is recorded, giving the dark adapted threshold. ठीक है. तो पहले रूम एक अंधेरे रूम में यू टेक द पेशेंट टू अ डार्क रूम लेट देम सिट देयर फॉर 30 मिनट्स आफ्टर दैट यू हैव अ पेंसिल लाइक थिंग ऑन व्हिच यू हैव अ लाइट द लाइट विल स्टार्ट एट अ वेरी लो इंटेंसिटी ओके एंड यू आस्क देम एट व्हाट इंटेंसिटी दे आर एबल टू सी सो यू कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग इंटेंसिटी अंटिल द पॉइंट एट व्हिच दे कैन सी सो दैट्स द मेजर यू विल से दैट आफ्टर 30 मिनट्स दे हैव बीन एबल टू अडॉप्ट टू दिस मच light sensitivity.
So dark adaptation curve can also be recorded by measuring the time taken during dark adaptation for subject to see a stimulus of a particular intensity. When this is seen, the intensity is reduced. ठीक है जैसे once the darkness is there, immediately you made the room dark. You showed them that light, okay, and asked them what is. You start from the lowest intensity and go up at what intensity they can see. So immediately if they have entered into the dark room, they will be able to see only at a high intensity level. Then after 5 minutes, you again repeat the test. So that way if you go, you will be able to plot that curve. You'll be able to plot this curve. So cones are only active until a particular intensity. So after a particular intensity, you will only be able to see, you will not be able to see colors. Okay. So after that you can only see bright or dark objects, but after that color sensitivity will go away. So that's what this one is showing here. Okay. Next I want to do is pulse oximeter. So pulse oximetry
for non-invasive measurement of arterial is used for non-invasive measurement of arterial oxygen saturation in the blood.
Pulse oximetry is used for non-invasive arterial
oxygen saturation in the blood. For the patients at risk of respiratory failure,
it is important to monitor the efficiency of gas exchange in the lungs. For patient at risk of respiratory failure, it is important to monitor the efficiency of gas exchange in the lungs. That is how well the arterial blood is oxygenated.
ठीक है. How well the arterial blood is oxygenated.
It was discovered in 1860s. That the colored substance in blood
is hemoglobin.
It was discovered in 1860s that the colored substance in blood is hemoglobin. and is also the carrier of oxygen. Which is the carrier of the which is the carrier of oxygen?
At the same time, it was noticed. At the same time, it was noticed that the absorption of visible light,
that the absorption of visible light by hemoglobin cell, by a hemoglobin solution, the absorption of visible light by a hemoglobin solution varied with oxygenation. Varied with oxygenation. This is because the two common forms of molecule, this is because the two common forms of the molecule, oxidized hemoglobin HbO2,
it is because the two common forms of the molecule, which is hemoglobin molecule, oxygenated hemoglobin, which is HbO2, and the reduced hemoglobin, which is Hb, have significantly different optical spectra, have significantly different optical spectra. This is because the two common forms of the molecule, oxidized hemoglobin HbO2 and reduced hemoglobin Hb, have significantly different optical spectra in the wavelength range from 500 nanometers to 1000 nanometers. In the wavelength range 500 nanometers to 1000 nanometers. Okay, so if you see, this is the, these are the spectra, absorption spectra of hemoglobin versus HbO2 between 500 and 1000 nanometers. So HbO2 has a different spectra and Hb has a different spectra. Oxygen saturation referred to as SaO2 or SpO2.
Oxygen saturation referred to as SaO2 or SpO2. SaO2 or SpO2. This is what is referred to as oxygen saturation. This is given by SpO2 is equal to percentage of how many hemoglobin molecules are oxygenated divided by total number of hemoglobin, both oxygenated and deoxygenated. So this is the percentage of oxygen saturation or SpO2.
Under normal physiological conditions, SpO2 is 97% to SpO2 for vein, arterial blood is 97%.
Under normal physiological conditions, SpO2 for arterial blood is 97%
and for venous blood is 75%. Under normal physiological conditions, arterial blood is 97% or SpO2 is equal to 97% and venous blood is SpO2 is 75%.
What does this mean? Why is it 75% in venous blood?
Where is the oxygen going? Yes, to the cells to do ATP kind of breathing and all. Okay, so that's why arterial blood has just come from through the lungs by absorbing oxygen. So that's why SpO2 is high and the, in the venous blood it is low.
So Friday I am not here. So Friday there will be no class. So only Thursday class, and Saturday is the two. So if you have any questions regarding your projects, if you want to talk with those doctors, depending on.
It's a good opportunity.